Draw front view, top view and left hand side view using first angle projection method of given isometric 3D view. Use unidirectional system for dimensioning. Now, as you know, for first angle method, here will be front view, then below front view it is top view, right side it is left hand side view, and left side it is right hand side view. So we will use this four quadrant, front view, top view and left hand side view, and over here it will be projections from top view to left hand side view or left hand side view to top view. So let us draw four quadrants. So here is the four quadrants. We will keep space between two diagram or plane line and diagram with 1 centimeter so that diagrams are separated, otherwise it is merged. So that is very difficult to differentiate two views without this projection lines. Now when we observe from this front view, 90 is the total length, talking about height, base height is 50 plus 70 up to center of the circle. From center of the circle to 40 up to center of this smaller circle, then radius of outer half circle is 15, so total it is 140. So let's consider height 140 for given object. Say over here it is total 140 by 90. Base I already told you that is 1.5, so here is the base height that is given 1.5 centimeter or 15 millimeter. So this one is the, now this line is not required, so it is projection light line. So this one is base, as we know it is total 140. Now after base it will be slope, but starting point of slope we know at base, but ending point we don't know. So let us look at directly 70. Above base it is 70, that is center of circle. From center, so center of 90 is 4.5, then let us draw center line so that it will be easy to complete example. Above base at perfect 70, it is center of circle. So here is the center of circle. Now let us draw these two circles, so it's easy. So 25 and 15 radius. So using rounder, keep 25 radius and draw circle. So this one is the circle and 15 circle, 15 millimeter radius circle. Both are concentric circle, so it's easy because we already situated or located center. So here are two circle that is concentric and according to question. Now when you see these two circles are not full circle, here gap is provided. With center both are symmetric gap, so that is gap is given 4. See, this one is continuous gap. So both side I will consider 2 millimeter gap. So total it will be 4. So both side with vertical line, it is 2 millimeter gap in both sides. So this will be our circle. Now talking about base, see base is start, sorry slope, this 10 mm slope is start from bottom of circle to top of base, 10 mm. So I will use 5 millimeter, or we can say 0.5 centimeter at both sides. So this one is finally our slope in front you. Now see this, when you see from front side, this one is visible, so that is inclined line from top of base to here. When you see, it is continuous, not separation is given, so continuous means it is same place, so it is tangent. This line will be tangent, so let's draw. So here is the bottom point and tangent, so this one is perfect tangent of circle. So likewise it is perfect, and finally in this side, so both are tangents and the slope at both sides are symmetric as this symmetric line is given. Now talking about top, when you see in front side, so this portion is visible vertical only up to center. From bigger circle center to center of the circle is 40 and height is 15, so total 55. So from center we will draw 55 millimeter height. So from here it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 55 will be over here. So finally this one, and in this case it's over here. So this one is total height. Now width of this thickness, or say width is 10, so I will consider 10 at both sides. So here is a 10 mm, and finally over here it is again 10. So again I will draw vertical line. And I will complete this top. So this one is the top side. Actually it is circle, but when you see from front, cylindrical part is visible as a straight only. Now let us talk about some hidden lines. Now this slope you already drawn, here is drawn. Now base circles is not visible behind this plane, so in that case we will draw hidden line. Let us locate center. So when you see, center is 20 mm from both boundaries, and this inside part is also 20 mm we will consider. So from this boundary it is 20 mm, and from this it is 20, so that is center of the circle. Radius of circle, total diameter is given 15, so it is 7.5. so say it is over here 7.5, and finally 15. In same way it is 7.5 radius and 15 diameter, so that will be hidden line. Hidden lines in base only, because that circles are provided in base. So throughout height of base, or we can say thickness of base, it is hidden line. Never cross boundary. So this one is the center line and two sided hidden line for this circle. Now talking about this base circle, it's horizontal like this. So say center of that circle is 15 mm below from top, and radius is 10 mm. So let's say center is 15 mm below, so it is over here, and radius is 10, so 5 5 mm both side. So let us say horizontal line, that is center line, 4 circles, and hidden line, so see, I started hidden line from here and end, that is circle ends, then again start and end, because two parts are given, in this part also hidden line and in this part. Now front view is over. Now let us take all the projections of front view in top view to draw top view of given object, or you can start side view also. So this one is the boundary projection, then projection of this circle, then here is the projection of center line, then projection of slope, again projection of boundary of circle, and here is the end. Let's consider projection of top portion also, and this one is the projection of slot that is cut in the top of circle. So these are the projections. Now let us start to draw. When we see from the top, it is perfect rectangle base is visible. Although these circles are there, but from top it is rectangle. So let me complete. Width of the object is 70. And length, when we see from the top, it is 90. We already got that 90. Cross 70. So again this one is the 90. And 70. Now in top view, let us situate this portion, or let me consider first these two circles. So it is start from end, rear end, पीछे एंड है, बैक एंड, वहाँ से स्टार्ट हो रहा है, देन टोटल विड्थ और से दिस थिकनेस ऑफ दिस टू सर्कल्स आर 50. सो लेट से दिस वन इज द बाउंड्री ऑफ बिगर सर्कल, से इट इज 50, सो इट्स ओवर हियर. इन सेम वे हियर ऑल्सो 50, एंड फाइनली I will consider end of boundary. So this one is the top view of circle, and here is the center line for this circle. Now on the top of circle, this portion is provided. So when we see from the top, it is rectangle part. This part is visible. And it will be start 10 mm gap from both side. Over here it is mentioned 10 mm. It is not throughout the circle. It is by considering gap of 10 mm. So here is the gap of 10 mm up to 10 mm gap. And width is over here. So this one is the width. In same way, both side of gap slope is, sorry, U shape portion is given. So this one is this two top mein jo hai features hai A shape portion, then circle is cut. So circle is at the center. So let us situate center. So it's over here, and it will be center line. Now talking about this slope. So it is start at the end, and over here base. So when it is easy to see from top, sorry, so from front view. So it is start over here and end over here, not at perfect center line. So and width of slope is given 10 mm. So I will draw 10 mm, but it is end over here, not at perfect boundary of circle. It's end over here in this direction. So here these two lines, object lines, should be removed because it is continuous part or it's tangent. So both are mix up. See over here, this both are mix up. It is not any boundary. So likewise, this all both parts are merged. So homogeneous, same material, we can say. Now see, this inner circle is not visible, so that will be hidden line. And in question, depth of inner circle is not given, so we will consider throughout this outer circle. So this one is the two hidden lines of this inner circle, this one two boundary. Now let's consider these top circles. So that is again not visible, so 10 mm both side, so that will be hidden line again. And finally this gap is visible throughout this object. So say over here is the projections of gap. So these are the projections. So here is represent of gap. This one is top portion, then circular part and two slope. Front slope is remaining, so it will be start and end over here, as you can see in our object. So it is start and end. So already we took projections. Finally, two circles are situated in base with corner 20-20 mm. So with this corner, let's say over here it is 20 millimeter center line. So that is and from top we can consider so this one is the corner is itself center. Now let's say 15 mm diameter is given, so it's 0.7. So this one is 0.7 radius and a draw circle. According to this diagram, it is very small, so you can use master circle to draw small radius circles. So in rounder it might be error. So over here that both circles, then inner circles are not visible, so that will be hidden lines. So you have to use master circle or rounder in the top view. Finally, this one is the top view of object for left hand side view. Let's consider projection from top view and front view, all the projections. So these are the projections from top view. and let's say vertical projection in left hand side view quadrant. Same way we will consider projections from front view. These are the boundaries of circle. And finally top. Center of these top circles. So I considered all the projections. Now let us start with side view. So in left hand side view again base is visible. We have already projections of base that is over here. So after base, here is the circle. So let's situate first circle easily. So circle is outer boundaries these two and starting point over here and ending point over here. So at this line it will be end. So let's say here is the circular why I drawn 10 centimeter only because see sorry 10 mm in both side 10 mm gap is there. So in that case I will draw only now this one is the portion of slope. So that slope is ends over here. See, this one is the end point of slope. So I will draw end point. So these two points are end point of slope. So we will extend this line, slope line, up to end point. And finally it's over here, that is end point. See, this one is the up to end point, not up to base of circle. So this one is the base of circle up to end point. So end point we can find from front view. Base is start and over here it is end. Inner circle. For inner circle, let us draw hidden lines. So it is directly available in the projections from front view. And over here it is. And finally this one is the and say top for top portion. This one is the top portion projection over here. It is vertical height that is up to 40 and we know it is up to here. So this will be our 40 mm height and that will be center point. So we can easily draw circle say this one is the top boundary and over here it is end. So here is the total I drawn final. So that is over here. Now for inner circle diameter is given 20, so it is 10 mm radius. So this one is the 10 mm radius and draw one circle from that. Again, if you have a master circle, so it is easy to draw. You need not to draw freehand circle. It should be perfect round. Now the slope is start from circle base. So here is the circle base and bottom top. So this one is the bottom top. So we will join that two part. And finally we have. Now base circles. When you see this one is the center of base circle only. So say here is the vertical center line and both sides of circle is let's say 7.5 as it is 15 mm diameter given. So finally this one is the left hand side view. So we can write LHSV. This one is the front view and top view. For first angle projection method, we will draw symbol also which indicate our diagram is in first angle projection system. So first draw two concentric circles . So these are the two concentric circles. Take the projection for left hand side view. And this one is the symbolically representation of first angle projection system. Now let us write some dimensions using unidirectional system as in question mentioned. So let's say base is given 90, then 15 height, 70 and 40. So let us say this base. Basically we are using two views in dimensioning. So let's me use front view and top view, but generally major dimensions will be available in the front view. Sorry, this one is the unidirectional, so we will write in the center of dimension 90. Same way, let's say here it is 15. Say here it is 40, 70, and this one is 15. Likewise, you have to give all the dimension which is given. Let's say R25 and R15. Let's say this one is the smaller circle. So for this circle it is R15 and for outer circle let's say R25. So likewise we can give all the dimensions in front view and top view. Yes, 50 dimension is not visible in both cases. Okay, in front top view it is visible. So let's say this one is 50. Using unidirectional system. So likewise give all the dimensions. Rarely you have to use side view. So better to use front view and top view for dimensioning.